My name is Inigo Montoya. You killed my father. Prepare to die.
Hey, my name is actually Bhaskar Sharma and my father is Hale and Hearty. And this is not a video about an outlaw who's out to avenge his father's murder. It's kind of more boring. It's about building a smart Facebook chatbot. I know. So, but if you are using a Facebook chatbot, you're gonna love this video because here I found out a way. I want to show you how I built a chatbot which doesn't just behave like a glorified app, mobile app, or a website or a navigation bar, which is a lot of bots are. You basically have a specific set of responses that the bot asks, and if you follow the response, for instance, the bot asks you to send an email, and if you type something else, the bot gets all confused and it all breaks, and the user experience is kind of shit for a lot of these bots because the user doesn't feel like they're chatting to a real person, which is the whole point of a bot, because it's a sort of a conversational thing. I found a way to incorporate artificial intelligence using natural language processing engine. This is built on Google, the natural language processing engine. It's called a service. There's a service called API.ai. This service basically uses all the fancy machine learning and NLP and AI. I don't really know what exactly it does. But what it does is it takes the responses from Chatfuel, or here in this example, I'm using Chatfuel to build my bot. So it takes the responses, the user responses that are not expected from Chatfuel. It processes the responses through, it runs its responses through its NLP engine, and it basically it basically shows the responses to the user in such a way that the user understands. What it does is, there are some things that you can do I'm not going to show you a lot of things here because I have not really set it up that much, but I have a use case. Suppose you have a restaurant and you have a bot which basically lets people order pizzas, burgers, whatever you, shows them the order status, tells them how far it'll take for the order to reach them, and there are a specific set of responses that the bot understands. So you click on a button that says order status on the bot. So the bot will depending on how it is set up, it will tell the user that, hey, your order is dispatched and it's going to reach you in 15 minutes. But what happens if the user, instead of tapping on that fixed button which the bot expects, it says, hey, where is my pizza? So if you have not incorporated some specific responses in Chatfuel's native artificial intelligence block, Chatfuel has an artificial intelligence service feature. Then the bot won't understand that. And there are so many variations of language. This is where, and so many variations of languages and so many variations of, you know, the same thing. We understand language. We understand hey, where is my pizza? That means that the order, that the customer wants their pizza status, but the bot is dumb. It doesn't understand the nuances of the language. And this is where the natural language processing tool comes in. So if your bot has that NLP thing built in, it's going to recognize a vast array of responses, which all means order status, and it's going to deliver a usable response. So I'm going to show you two examples, and let's get started on this. So I have a dumb bot right now. The bot that you see is a dumb bot. It's a lead gen bot, and this bot basically asks, introduces you to a series of services. Your services, for instance, this is a bot that I built to ask people if they want to build a bot of their own. So if I click on this, it's kind of meta, as you can see. If I click on the yes here, which is what the bot expects and which is what normally all bots do, then I'll get a standard set of response which bot now asks me to send my email, and then it'll ask me to send a Skype, and then also ask me to set appointment with software and good. But what happens if I type something like I am bored? You have given users the option to type, and people do that. Even if you have specific questions, sometimes people just type something. So there you go. It doesn't recognize it. Anyway. So it doesn't seem to be an email. Perhaps there is a typo somewhere, and obviously people will not really do this, but you never know. This is a simple use case, so never know. This is a smart bot. This is a bot for a mortgage broker, which basically asks people information about the loan services, information about loan, about their financial status, if they are seeking to get a home loan. So if I click on this, I'll get a normal, the bot flow will come. I can show you this later, but what if I click on something like, you know, how are you? You are hot. How old are you? So as you can see, this looks like a party trick, but as I told you before, there are a lot of options that you can do with this, given that the API AI service is integrated with Facebook Messenger, which means that you can send photos, you can send a clickable link, you can send a GIF, you can send a lot of things, you can send everything which basically a Facebook Messenger is capable of. So the scope is ultimately practically limitless, and you can do a lot of things like pulling things from a database, you can show map locations, whatever. So if this is interesting, and I believe that it's going to be interesting for you, I'm going to put the link of the tutorial that I followed in the comment below. So check it out and build it on your own. It takes some time. There are a bunch of services you need to sign up for, and you need to configure, and there is some tech stuff going on. It's more or less copy paste, but you still need to do some groundwork. Do that, and if you want a bot of your own, give me a ping. You know where I am. Montoya out.